Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome. We're excited to be here today. My name is Raquel Capellan. I'm the program coordinator with Breast Cancer Support Services, also known as BCSS. Welcome to Beyond Breast Cancer. Today, we have our guests. So we're going to be speaking a little bit about BCSS before I go ahead and introduce the guests that we have today. But so today's show is with the El Poder Advisory Committee, El Poder del Rosado, which is the Latina or Latino Latinx support group that we have through Breast Cancer Support Services. So a little bit about BCSS. So BCSS itself is called Breast Cancer Support Services. It's a survivor-driven nonprofit organization that provides hope, information, and support, and emotional support especially, to every person affected by breast cancer, especially those that reside here in Berks County that are impacted by breast cancer every single day. So the conception of BCSS began in fall of 1993, so we've been around for quite some time, and we're just really excited to kind of just get the ball rolling this year, next year, and the next couple of years to make sure that people know that BCSS, Breast Cancer Support Services, is a resource right here for organizations and for breast cancer survivors right here, right now in Berks County. Some of the initial goals of Breast Cancer Support Services were to implement support groups such as El Poder del Rosado, African American Support Group, and many other support groups, Pink Power Night programs, lunch and learns, and stuff like that, to make sure that our survivors are well taken care of. We established a support line and also compiled a resource book, amongst many other things. Also, these programs, just as a reminder, are provided at no cost at all, so they are completely 100% free to breast cancer survivors right here in Berks County, regardless of their socioeconomic circumstances, where they receive medical treatment during their cancer journey. Just as a reminder, we do not offer medical advice. However, information may be shared on personal experiences, treatment, etc. So, moving forward to introduce today's guests, I have Violet Emery with me today. Violet Emery is a career advisor at the Berks Latino Workforce Development Corporation, also known as Berks Tech Centro. Welcome, Violet. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Thank you, Raquel, for having me.
Of course, of course. And thank you. You know, Violet is also a member on our El Poder del Rosado Advisory Committee team. So thank you so much, Violet, for all of the work and time that you have put into to be on this committee with us. It's very important. And then second, we have Iñabel Ruiz, who is the Director of Human Services at the Centro Hispano, also known as the Hispanic Center.
Thank you, Raquel. It's an honor for me actually to be here and be able to provide information about the services that Centro has for our community. I'm pretty sure that even though we've been in the community for over 50 years, right. It has actually been probably a smaller portion that know what we do.
Right.
And this just gives us a perfect opportunity to discuss it so that we can serve more people.
100%. That is definitely the goal of all of us, right? Because I think the thing is, you know, a lot of nonprofits in Berks County, there's so much greatness here. There's hundreds of nonprofits, probably a few thousand maybe. I don't know the exact number, but you know, there's so much resources that Breast Cancer Support Services provides, the Centro Hispano, Hispanic Center provides, Berks Tech Centro, Latino Workforce Development provides, and so many other organizations and resources and programs that are out there. And even though it's a small yet mighty community, you know, the thing is that many people really don't really know their resources sometimes. So, you know, let's dive a little bit into that a little bit. So back to you, Violet. Can you tell us a little bit more about your services? Maybe tell us a little bit more about your role as a career advisor, what you do. Let's tell the people.
Yes.
Let's share all the information and knowledge.
As Raquel so kindly introduced, I'm a career advisor with Berks Latino Workforce Development. We're a nonprofit located in South Reading. Our address is 450 South 6th Street in Reading. We offer services as which include employment services. We're offering English classes, ESL. Coming in the future, we're going to be offering a HISET GED program. We also offer employment services, which is a big piece of what we do for the community, financial literacy and digital literacy. Currently, we have a component of our ESL course that includes digital literacy, so our students are learning English, but also learning how the basics of working with a computer and technology. So we also have a partnership with IBM. Really, you know, everybody knows IBM. We're offering free training, occupational training on that platform. All our services are free. If anybody wants to reach out and wants to, you know, learn more about our services, we're here to serve our community. You can reach me at 484-513-3344. My email is emoryv@blwdc.org. We're here to help everybody. Anybody that, our mission is to empower workers. Our services are all inclusive, even though we focus on the Latino community. So if anybody needs help, just come in. Our doors are always open. We're in the office from usually 8 to 5. And come in. We'll do what we can to help you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Violet. So you did mention that's actually something I learned. So all of the resources and programs through Berks Tech Central are 100% free as well?
Yes, absolutely. Our services are free.
Including the classes and everything?
The classes are free.
Okay.
I forgot to mention our medical courses that we'll be offering in the near future.
Awesome.
We're currently recruiting for our nurse's aid program that should be starting shortly. In the future, we're looking at offering a phlebotomy course and, a phlebotomy course and a medical assistant course. Also, we're gonna get into some further occupational training, which will be construction, plumbing, and culinary. That's in the future. That's, you know, part of our mission, and we hope to be able to offer all those services to the community in the near future.
How can people get better connected with you or with the Berks Tech Central?
Yes, they can reach me, or our number is 484-513-3344. Our website is www.blwdc.org.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Violet. So I would also like to read your bio. And then I'll go ahead and read your Ziñabel, and then you can go ahead and speak a little bit, you know, just like Violet did, more about the Centro Abriendo Puertas and what you guys do.
Okay.
So Violet Emery is a Berks County native and currently serves as a career advisor, like she just mentioned, for the Berks Latino Workforce Development Corporation. Prior to this position in the nonprofit sector, she worked and retired as deputy in charge of the federal court system, a position she held for 34 years. Thank you for your service, Violet.
Okay.
She also has a background in the mental health field, working with mandated clients who are navigating through family court and criminal justice systems. Violet enjoys working with community organizations and Berks County employers to develop partnerships with organizations and who align with the mission of the Berks Latino Workforce Development Corporation, and who also have the end goal of course, bettering and serving our community. Her current position as a career advisor affords her the ability to work with Berks County residents who are embarking on a career path with the goal of long-term sustainability. On to Ziñabel Ruiz. Ziñabel Ruiz is the Human Services Director at Centro Hispano. She's been working for the Centro Hispano Hispanic Center for approximately 10 years in various roles. Thank you so much, Ziñabel, for all your work.
Thank you.
She currently oversees the Information and Referral Department, the Abriendo Puertas or Opening Doors Program, the Health of Five Program, Higher Education Initiative, and the STOP Program, which is prevention and education on domestic and sexual violence. She holds a bachelor's degree in applied psychology from Albright College and loves working with the community. She believes that working with families has been an opportunity for her to reach out to the Spanish-speaking community, other agencies, and other organizations that work with Latinos or Latinas and the community in general, because, you know, we're all inclusive all the time, to support and improving the quality of life for our community. Thank you so much, ladies. So, Iñabel, can you tell us a little bit more about the programs just mentioned? And
Yes, absolutely. We have so many programs at the Hispanic Center, and I know that sometimes our community isn't necessarily aware of everything that we do in collaboration with many other agencies in the community. Centro Hispano has been around for over 50 years now, and currently we have the Information and Referral Department, that's advocacy for our population, and it can be anyone in the community that seeks our services. And what we do with Information and Referral is people will call us, and it depends on what the need is,
absolutely,
that we will be able to connect them with either other services in the community, other agencies that might be able to help with whatever assistance or service they might need, or we will do it ourselves. Now, currently, through the pandemic, Information and Referral, we've dedicated ourselves to really assist our clients with unemployment, with applying for benefits, with connecting them with other services and agencies in the community. In addition to Information and Referral, we do have one of the largest senior centers in Pennsylvania, which is Mami Angie's Casa de la Amistad.
Right.
It's for our seniors 60 years of age and older. And anybody who's 60 and over can, our older adults, right? They need services. And what we do is we provide meals. We provide congregate meals. They can actually come in and enjoy some activities. During the pandemic, that slowed down, and we had to slow that down a little bit, but we're open up again.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want more information, please give us a call to register. Anyone who's 60 and over can register to receive those services. We have our higher education initiative. We do have a scholarship which just closed, I think it was March 15th. It usually opens from January to March, and it's for anyone who's seeking a scholarship can apply, and that's one of the programs that we have. We also have a collaboration that we've had for many, many years with what used to be Berks Women in Crisis, which is now Safe Berks. And we do offer prevention and education, and we listen to, so anybody can come in. We offer advocacy on domestic violence and sexual violence. So, you know, you're not in this alone. We're here to support and also to connect with additional services from Safe Berks. We also have our at-risk dinner and snack program. That's for the Olivet's boys and girls. We prepare meals, after-school meals, for the kids and the teens, the youth. And we also have a medical interpreting program. We actually have medical interpreters that go to medical appointments with our seniors. The reasoning behind that is that we want to make sure that our seniors do get services that they need and that they understand how to take their medications, exactly what's going on, and that the doctor understands them, that they understand what the instructions are, and that makes the world of difference, connecting that human contact there at that appointment with our seniors, and that's really important. We also have our meals program to Head Starts. So we provide meals to all the Head Start classes in the county. So I think right now that we're actually providing, preparing at the Centro about 1,900 meals per day, and that also includes the Meals on Wheels program. So we're really actually very busy with our meals program and the Senior Center. And then we did also that COVID-19 initiative where we actually had a connection. We connected with the hospitals and other pharmacies in the community to be able to get our seniors and our population vaccinated.
Absolutely.
Just to make sure, you know, that we're safe, that everybody's safe and connected, because sometimes there is such a lack of information out in the community. And at the end of the day, what we're trying to do, our Centro's mission is kind of to improve the quality of life of our community in general.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for sharing.
That's great.
Iñabel.
And I didn't talk about Abriendo Puertas, which is the biggest initiative. It is our parent engagement program. We are committed to supporting our parents in the community. We talk about early intervention. We talk about early literacy, the importance of parents being the first and foremost, most important teacher of our children. We support them with resources in the community. We connect them with other parents and engage them. These classes right now are being offered virtually. They used to be in person. Now they're virtual. It is a 9-session program, and it's been working phenomenal. By the way, tomorrow we have a graduation. We're graduating 5 sessions, about 60 parents.
Congratulations.
The Abriendo Puertas, this is probably our biggest success, and we're going to go for more. We want to try to graduate about 200 parents this
year.
Can
you tell us how people can get involved? Like, how can parents get involved? Like, what the exact criteria is for them
all
to
of it,
participate?
All of it is free of charge.
Gotcha.
All they need to do is call us. We will register them for the next available session.
Yeah.
We will provide instruction on how to connect via Zoom. Mm-hmm. And then all they have to do is connect for about an hour and 15 minutes while we, all of us, discuss, because it's an engagement program, so we're all in it to support one another, and we provide resources, we provide information, we discuss relevant issues that are going on in the community with the parents right now. We discuss education, family success. It's just a wonderful, wonderful program, and I haven't heard any parent who's ever said to us, I'm not interested in the program, or I don't want the best for my child. We all want success mm-hmm. for our children, and that's what we do. We just offer that support, that engagement, that we're here to help you. Not that you don't know anything, because parents already know, and they're the most, they already are the experts on their own children.
Absolutely.
But, I mean, who couldn't use a little bit of assistance, support, and instruction sometimes, even with discipline issues? So we really discuss all of these issues. We provide information, and then at the end of it all, we are also providing a graduation, so they feel part of something and they've accomplished something, mm-hmm. that it's for them. It's a beautiful program, and we're just really excited about continuing to provide it for our communities.
Absolutely.
It's beautiful.
Well, ya tu sabes, mi gente, you already know my people.
Yeah.
Go out and get these resources and take advantage of the resources that, you know, as you're a breast cancer survivor and need any support or any resources, or know any breast cancer survivors, even you ladies, you
Absolutely.
Know, and you, Violet, and myself and everybody else that's part of our El Poder del Rosado Advisory Committee mm-hmm. have talked about these things, and have talked about the need, especially to expand. And that's something that BCSS has been very diligently working on. We're really working very, very hard every single day to make sure that we're reaching every single community as best as we can, which, you know, I'll dive into a little bit more into that now. So just explaining a little bit more about what El Poder del Rosado is. So El Poder del Rosado, tongue twister, has existed since about 2015, possibly maybe a little bit earlier. I started participating in breast cancer support services myself since earlier last year, just in generally wanting to get involved because it's a cause that is near and dear to my heart, and that I really care about. And, you know, I think just that our community just needs more resources and education on, what's out there. So just to read a little bit more about the mission statement of El Poder. So El Poder del Rosado enhances the quality of life for the Hispanic and Latino community by providing breast health awareness through comprehensive education and emotional support programs to empower those with a breast cancer diagnosis, family, friends, and all throughout Berks County. Our vision statement is, El Poder del Rosado strives to provide local support, inclusion, and hope to the Hispanic and Latino community where culturally appropriate communication can occur. We advocate for your needs through every stage of your journey. And, you know, that's another good thing about BCSS, whether it's someone who's been newly diagnosed within the last few days to, you know, last few years, or they're, you know, someone who's out 10, 15, 20, 30, 50 years out of their survivorship. It doesn't matter, you know, what you look like, how many years you've dealt with, you know, this very vicious illness. we're here as a resource to support you. And I went off a little tangent, but just to read a little bit of the rest of our vision statement, we advocate for your needs through every stage of your journey and provide resources that are relevant to the culture and situation of those who attend together. We offer support for the whole person by providing information, empathy, and friendship to any breast cancer survivor, especially, you know, who's Latina, who needs that support. So we also have a leadership opportunity with the El Poder del Rosado Advisory Committee. We are actually actively recruiting. So Inyabel, if you're, you know, interested in joining us, or if you know anybody else, you know, we're looking for more, maybe even Latina survivors within Berks County that have dealt with the illness. You know, I've talked to a few people and have had quite some very engaging conversations with people. So I'm hoping to recruit about 4 to 6 more people to be part of the advisory committee. And just in general, you know, the advisory committee is to serve as a support to me, but also to generally and eventually within the next few months, create and establish a sustainable support group for Latina breast cancer survivors within Berks County. We also, our meetings occur once a month. They are the second Tuesday of each month at 4 p.m. via Zoom, but we will also be moving towards meeting in person, whether it's at the office or maybe even Berks Deck Centro, maybe even the Centro Hispano, once we develop, you know, a stronger relationship and partnership with you guys, just to make sure that we're representing different organizations and giving each other the opportunity to connect, network, and discuss the resources that we provide, and establish and continue that support group that will, we are very, you know, working very hardly every single day to make sure that we establish that support group for our Latina breast cancer survivors. So a little bit about that, and then moving forward, cancer knows no party. You might have heard of it, you may have not. If you didn't, you're hearing about it now, and I hope you spread the word. If you're watching this, or if you're watching this BCTV show with, you know, me, Inyabel, and Violet later on today or another day. So Cancer Knows No Party is actually my personal introduction to breast cancer support services. Cancer Knows No Party is actually a first-time event. So it's a first-time event that we are planning just to bring together a very diverse group of people. So just to read a little bit more about Cancer Knows No Party, did you know that each year more than 300 Berks County women are diagnosed with breast cancer? Did either of you know that?
I knew that.
You knew that,
yes.
Because we
I
talked
did not
about
know
it.
That. Talked about
right.
It, yes.
So yeah, that's actually, you know, outstanding, not in the best way, statistic
exactly.
Regarding that, and even, you know, probably more so now that, you know, the pandemic has just, or endemic at this point, but the pandemic in general over the past 2 years has just added a lot of fuel to that fire. So we know that cancer truly knows no party and can impact anyone at any moment. Developing and maintaining a strong support system, especially when encountering a breast cancer diagnosis, is crucial. Cancer Knows No Party, very excited for it. It's a first-time event created by Breast Cancer Support Services and led by the BCSS El Poder del Rosado Advisory Committee to empower and connect the Berks County community with local resources and organizations such as BCSS, Berks Tech Centro, the Centro Hispano, Barrio Alegría, New Journey Community Outreach, and many other nonprofits that will be there. We'll also be having the One Love Project and a very big, diverse group of nonprofits, organizations, even elected officials such as State Representative Manny Guzman, Commissioner Michael Rivera, Commissioner Leinbach, Commissioner Kevin Barnhart, Mayor Eddie Moran and his administration will be there, Senator Judy Schwenk, and many others. So if I didn't get to mention your name, add that to the end, many others. But we'll be having a very diverse group of people, from elected officials to community organizations to leaders such as you two great ladies, and just many other people, including BCSS. And shout out to the Olivets, the Oakbrook Olivets, for allowing us to be there, allowing us to have the event hosted by there. So Cancer Knows No Party is going to be a great event. One, mostly because we're bringing a very big, diverse group of people together. We'll have survivors also here and share their stories. Elected officials will be and organizations will be speaking and sharing resources at their tables. And also while speaking, they'll be informing the community of what they provide to the community, but also just in general as a way to bring people together, right? You know, cancer is something that we're all impacted by, you know, as we can all agree, whether it's indirectly or, or directly. I've personally been impacted by it, by losing my stepmother to it last year. And it just kind of set me on fire in a very positive way. And it just reminded me, one, that life is too short, you know, as I'm sure we can all agree on, and just reminding ourselves that cancer literally knows no party. It knows no bounds. El cáncer no tiene partido. And that'll be occurring on Thursday, April 28th, 2022. So it's right around the corner. So again, Cancer Knows No Party is taking place Thursday, April 28th, 4:30 p.m. to 7 p.m. at the Oakbrook Olivets. That's 1161 Pershing Boulevard, Reading, PA, 19611. So join us that night for some good food, snacks, and fellowship with other nonprofits, other community leaders, other elected officials of all sides of the spectrum, because it really doesn't matter what you believe in. Well, it does matter. That sounded weird, but, you know, we all value each other. We all value our beliefs. And I just really hope that, you know, this event is really the spark and one of the big initiatives of this year that can continue to improve and connect ties across all kinds of people, all different organizations throughout this entire county, because it's so needed.
I agree with you, Raquel. Awareness is so important in our community, and early detection is so very important. And this is a perfect opportunity for getting to know what resources are available, what support services are available out in the community. We're all gonna be there together to support our community, our Latinas, our Latinos, who are survivors, who are living with breast cancer. So I think it's just an excellent opportunity for us to continue to provide support.
100%, I'm 100% in agreement, Yavel. And a little bit more about our sponsors for Cancer Knows No Party. We have Visions Federal Credit Union, Penny Health Insurance, Highmark Wholecare, which was previously known as Gateway Health, AmeriHealth Caritas, Galfin and Berger Law. So thank you so much. And Keller Williams Platinum Team Rivera, thank you so much, Commissioner Michael Rivera and Zilka Rivera for deciding to sponsor our event. It means the world to us. And a little bit more about our community partners that I just previously mentioned. We'll also be having the Dominican Association of Pennsylvania, the NAACP Reading Branch, the Oakbrook Olivets Boys and Girls Club, the Berks County Chapter, Safe Berks, and many other wonderful organizations. Here's how to register. So you can register for Cancer Knows No Party by emailing me at raquel@bcssberks.org or calling our BCSS office at 610-478-1447. Just a reminder, seating is limited. We are expecting a big crowd of about 75 to 100 people. So spread the word, right?
That's
I'm gonna need your help,
that's
everybody
amazing.
Else's help.
Yes,
I wanna bring everybody together. So let's do it together. You know, registration is required. So just make sure if you're interested in attending Cancer Knows No Party, please contact us like as soon as possible. That way we can make sure that you have a seat reserved for Cancer Knows No Party. And here's some ways to volunteer with us. You can visit BCSS website, contact Vanessa at bcssberks.org, our social media coordinator and director. You can contact us to volunteer, and there's different ways to donate as well. So thank you so much for supporting Breast Cancer Support Services. We'll see you next time. Thank you. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you, Raquel.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.